Now let's talk about the Prowl Governor. In Prowl Governor, you know, the majority of the configuration is same as the Porter Governor, but you have these extended arms on which the fly balls are attached. Like Porter, you also have a weighted sleeve at the center. Rest everything is same. Okay, so if you have to draw a free body diagram for this part, okay, this will be it. So you will have O point O, which is the point of pivot. Then you have point B. Then you have point E. On this point E, you have half the weight acting, which is on the sleeve. Then you have weight W1 for the balls, and then you have the centrifugal force FC acting at point C, which is the left ball. And then you have angles alpha and then beta, and T1 and T2, which is almost same as the Porter Governor. Now, let's start by considering the equilibrium at point E. So you will have T2 cos beta is equal to W by 2. So I can write down T2 cos beta is equal to W by 2, where T2 is W upon 2 cos beta. Now let's look at the equilibrium at point B. Equilibrium at point B, and that too in a vertical direction, would be T1 cos alpha. This is equal to W1 plus, this will be T2 cos beta. Alright, so T2 cos beta is W by 2, so this will become W1 plus W by 2. So this is the value of T1 cos alpha when we take the equilibrium at point B for the vertical forces. Now we'll consider the same thing at point C. Okay, so or I would say, let's take the moments about point E. So when you take the moments about point E, you get FC into CF, FC into CF. Okay, and then you have W1 into EF, okay, or FE, whatever it is. Then you have, this is T1 cos alpha into FE, so this will be minus T1 cos alpha into FE, and then we have T1 sin alpha into BF, minus T1 sin alpha into BF equal to 0. So this is taking moments about point E. So when we find the value for FC, the value for FC comes out to be BF upon CF into, we will get W1 plus W by 2 into tan alpha plus W by 2 into tan beta. I can take tan alpha common, so which will give me, and I can, before I do that, let's put this equal to W1 by G into omega square R. Okay, where R is this distance, this is R. Okay, so you will have W1 by G into omega square R is equal to BF upon CF into, I can take tan alpha common. Okay, so you will have tan alpha common into W by 2 into 1 plus K plus W1, where K is equal to tan beta upon tan alpha. Okay, so this is the expression that you get. Okay, I can also write down the value for tan alpha, which is, if you look at this triangle, it is R by H, isn't it? So when you put tan alpha as R by H, you get W1 by G into omega square. Your R is now gone because you have R by H over here, and this R is gone. Okay, then you get equal to BF upon CF into 1 by H into W by 2 into 1 plus K plus W1. So this is the expression where K is tan beta by tan alpha. So make a note of this, okay, and the rest it is everything same as the Porter governor. So I hope you understood the Powell governor as well. Now let's have a look at some examples on the three governors that we have done up till now, that is Watt governor, Porter governor and the Powell governor.